Hey everyone, I'm Sarah Fish.
And I'm Brandon Price.
And this is Fish
or Price Ranch.
Hey everyone, welcome back. I'm Sarah with Fish or Price Ranch. First off, please don't forget to subscribe and like this video. So we're back out here in the dough pen, and I'm going to show you guys what happened. We were actually home, but I missed the entire thing. Opal had her babies. Now these are out of Onyx, and yes, one of them does have extra teats. So they're unfortunately going to be cold as well. But it also looks like we have another doe that's not due for another 2 days, and it looks like she might be in early labor. So here is Opal, and she had a little white buck and then a colored doe. She's being a great mom. We were home. She was acting uncomfortable, but we went inside to do some paperwork. And when we came back out, she was already done. So the little doe has a fish teat. The buck is one by one, but Onyx is definitely throwing these extra teats on the kids. So good news is Tipsy, this is GOT Tipsy Fiddler, she is bred to Bazooka, so hopefully we should not have any extra teats. But she's been kind of off by herself. She is very talkative. And as you can see, she's kind of dug herself a little hole here. So I just came out to check on her. I've been checking on her throughout the day, and her udder is very full. So I'm going to see if maybe she's about ready to have these kids. So we're going to, see how big her udder is right there. And yeah, she's looking real uncomfortable. So I'm thinking she's getting pretty close to popping these kids out. So fingers crossed we get some more girls. We definitely need some. She's been really big almost the whole pregnancy. So who knows, maybe she's got three in there. We had her before. She had twins for us. We sold her, which we regretted, but we were able to luckily buy her back. But while she was gone, she had twins. So she's known for having twins, but we'll see what happens. So while we're actually waiting on Tipsy, I'm going to talk to you about these two girls. If you guys remember, Truffles last year had twin girls. She rejected them, and then eventually later the next day she ended up taking them and was a great mom. We sold both the doelings. These were the only two does that we had sold last year. If you guys remember, we didn't have very many girls. So we sold them to a friend, and they did 4-H with them. Well, because of certain circumstances, they came back. And so here's what they look like now. And they look really good. We do have one. She actually has a hernia. I'm assuming she got injured. And so she's got a lump on her side there. We're going to watch it to see if it heals. It's not bothering her otherwise. But if it doesn't heal, we'll have to make a decision on if we want to do a surgery or cull her. So we'll just see what happens. But they did come home. And then our other doe that looks like she's going to go today, we'll see. She won't let me check for ligaments, but that's Capers Jr. And see if I can get around to show you her. She gave us Daphne last year out of Wrecker. This year we bred Caper Jr. to Wrecker's son, Hawthorne. And she's a heavy milker, really, really nice doe. As you can see, her udder is huge. And she's pretty sunken in around her tail. She will not let me check her ligaments. But we're definitely keeping a really close eye on her today as well. And then this is one of the quads that Divinity had. This is one of her boys. Hi, buddy. They are having to be supplemented. We actually just started today. They are week and a half or so old now, and so we're just going to supplement them twice a day. Hi, buddy. Hi. But everybody's look nice and healthy. Otherwise, mom, I think, is just having a hard time. It's so many to take care of, and she's only a second time mom, and I think she's a little stressed out about it. She's nursing them all, but I don't think she's nursing often enough. So unfortunately, we're having to bottle feed. I think we're just going to do twice a day. Should be enough for these guys. So Tipsy just got up. We're going to go see what she's doing over here. Looks like she's going to turn around and start digging. So I think she's just about ready to pop these kids out. Yep, there she goes. She's digging. I wasn't expecting her to kid already. She's 2 days early, which isn't bad. but I'm definitely very excited to see these kids. Well, I'm not quite sure what's going to happen. I just sat down here with Tipsy, and now Capers Jr. is over there by the tree by herself. So I guess I'm going to have to keep an eye on both of them. Well, it looks like her water just broke. She's got a bunch of fluid suddenly. So it looks like it's about that time. She's just starting to push. She had the sack pop, and there's a foot, there's a little bit of yellow, so she's having, the baby's having a little bit of trouble, so I'm just going to be prepared in case I need to help, but so far it looks like she's doing all right. We got 2 feet presenting, and they're presenting in the right way, and I see her nose right after, so I don't think she's going to need any help. So far, she's doing good. Keep pushing, Mom. Good job. Gotta get that head out. It's alive. I can see it moving. Good job, Mom. She's doing a good job, but I'm just gonna give her a little bit of assistance. If I pull on one of these legs, it'll help open up and give more room for that head to come out. Here, go back. So just pull this leg out. Just one. You don't want to ever do two. There we go. There's the head. Good job, Mom. Yeah, see how the mucus is yellow. The baby was in just a little bit of distress, but not too bad. Good job. That's a big baby. My guess is it's probably a buck. Let's just move it out of your way here. And, oh, it's a doe. Very good job, Tipsy. Yeah, you got a baby girl. I always double check my thoughts here. Oh, yeah, that's definitely a vulva on that baby. Very nice. Figured it would be red because Mom has thrown red and Bazooka's red. Good job. We got a little girl. That's a big baby, so my guess is she might just have twins in there if they're both this size. She just started pushing while standing up. So see if I can get around and see what she's having. Yep, we got some legs presenting. See how this fluid is clear? So it gives you kind of an idea of the difference in the last one that was born. Another set of large feet. So she may just have twins. They're just going to be larger. Good girl. That little doling is so cute. She looks really nice. Good mama. See a nose presenting. Good job, mom. Be nice if we got twin does. We need to catch up on does. We're having a lot of boys again. Be nice to get some more girls. Gotta keep pushing, Mom. Working on that head. Keep pushing, almost, Mama. Almost. One more good one. Here you go. Almost have it. There it is. Good job. This one looks black and white. Get past some shoulders. Hi, little one. There it is. Good job, Mom. You gotta finish pushing it the rest of the way out, silly. There it is. That was funny. Here it is. What'd you have? Look at that, another baby. Good job, Mom. Yeah, she could be done. That could be the part of her afterbirth right there. Let's see what we've got here. We have what looks like a boy. Get your nose clear. Hold on. Here a sec. There we go. Now you can breathe. That better? Yep, definitely a boy. And one by one teats on both, which is great. Bazooka's never thrown extra teats on his kids before, so that's good. But we have a red and black doe and a black and white buck. Wait and see. I think she might be done because that's part of her afterbirth coming out, but we'll see what happens. Babies are all dry. They're nursing. Good job. Mama did good. Looks like just the two. She just dropped her afterbirth right over there. She's all done. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed that video. We're very excited to finally get these kids on the ground, other than our disaster of a situation with Onyx, unfortunately. So it's nice to have good quality kids finally hitting the ground again. Thank you guys again, and we'll see you next time.